The Fundo Riolito shower bases feature a contemporary linear drain. These bases can be easily customized for almost any shower space and include single slope options like the Riolito line module and Riolito extension we are using today. It utilizes our simple click and seal drain assembly. Our installer will be installing the Fundo Riolito on a level 3/4 inch plywood substrate with 16-inch on-center joists. Please consult with your dedicated wedi technical sales support manager if you encounter different framing and or substrates than this. All wedi shower bases can be installed on concrete slabs as well. A 5-inch diameter hole is cut in the subfloor where the pipe will be installed for the drain connection. The plumber only needs to leave the pipe stubbed up past the subfloor. Our installer uses a 2-foot square and an oscillating tool to cut the 2-inch pipe flush to 1/8 inch higher than the subfloor. Remove any remaining burrs and debris after the cut. Be sure to use all necessary PPE such as safety glasses, ear protection, and a dust mask throughout the installation. The wedi Fundo Riolito and Riolito line modules utilize our click and seal drain system. When the Riolito line module is ready to be installed, the first step is attaching the drain body. Remove all internal components from the drain body. These will be used later on for a watertight connection. To install the drain body on the underside of the line module, first apply a small amount of the included lubricant to the entire surface of the rubber gasket on the drain body. You will then place the drain body into the threaded drain area of the shower base and simply turn clockwise until you hear a click. Ensure the drain is properly threaded and completely seated. Single indicating hash marks on the drain will line up with double hash marks on the Riolito unit if the drain is in the correct position. The line module is now ready for installation. It is now time to prepare the extension module for installation. Dry fit the drain module for accurate measuring. Find your desired length and remember to account for the curb and rabbit channels when doing so. Working from the bottom of the base, mark the extension module to your desired length. Remember, due to the single slope, the module is only modifiable in length. Use a circular saw to cut the base. Some size blades may not go all the way through on the first pass. You may need to complete the cut with an extendable blade or handsaw. Dry fit both the drain and extension module to ensure all modifications are accurate. On the modified edge of the extension module, a rabbet channel will have to be re-notched to receive the curb. Working now from the top of the extension module, mark 1/2 inch from the perimeter on the modified side. Draw a line from end to end. Set the depth of your circular saw 1 inch above the bottom of the base. This is important as a curb will later wrap around this corner. Run a depth cut from end to end of the shower base, carefully following your line. Measure up from the bottom 1 inch on either side and make a mark. Using a straight edge, mark a line. It is very important to keep the channel level and consistent. Use a sharp utility blade and in a few passes, cut through until the depth cut and the side cut meet. Use your utility knife to fit any imperfection in this channel. Your substrate should be free and clear of any debris before applying thinset. This is necessary to achieve an optimal bond. Using a 1/2 inch by 1/2 inch square notch trowel, apply modified thinset to the clean substrate. Applying thinset on both the base and the substrate with a 1/4 by 1/4 notch trowel is also acceptable. Use directional troweling to ensure proper coverage. You will also use the flat side of the trowel to back butter the underside of the Riolito line module. A modified thinset is always recommended when installing a wedi shower base. press the module firmly into the thinset. Clean any excess thinset while keeping the module and channels clean. Using the internal drain components from earlier, you will apply lubricant to the sealing gasket. Place the gasket around the pipe and seat it fully to the bottom of the drain body. With Riolito shower bases, the compression spacer will get cut into two pieces. The areas to cut are marked on each side. Add lubricant to the inside gasket of each piece of the compression spacer. Install spacer one piece at a time around the pipe and on top of the sealing gasket already in place. Now, using a counterclockwise direction, thread the locking key in place and tighten fully with the strainer key and a flathead screwdriver. The strainer key remains in place to provide a convenient hair catch for the end user. Using a 1/2 inch by 1/2 inch square notch trowel, apply modified thinset to the clean substrate. Use directional troweling to ensure proper coverage. You will also use the flat side of the trowel to back butter the underside of the Riolito extension. A modified thinset is always recommended when installing a wedi shower base. Apply a 1/2 inch bead of sealant to the channel of the line module. You will also apply a 1/2 inch bead of sealant to the channel on the extension. Always keep the thinset and sealant separate. We will apply a second bead of sealant on the face of the extension or line module. Gently lay the extension into the thinset. Apply pressure to the seam of the extension and line module. To ensure proper coverage, walk on top of the pan, starting from the back, and slowly force out any air still beneath the base. Take a flat knife to remove any squeeze out of sealant. Wedi building panels are 100% waterproof and provide excellent strength for tile installations. The installer is using 1/2 inch building panels. After ensuring the framing is plumb and studs are no further than 16 inches on center, measure for the first panel. The installer will be using 4x5 1/2 inch panels. When measuring your wall, Wedi building panels will always have to end supported on a stud. You will want to notch the panel around the base so the curve will be fully supported when installed. Plan for all protrusions, fixtures, and any other cuts that may be needed. Using a utility knife, score the top side of the building panel until you are completely through the first cementitious layer and mesh. You can then snap the panel and cut completely through to the other side. Wedi panels are virtually dust-free and safe to cut on any job site. When creating cutouts for your mixing valve and other plumbing, a utility knife or handsaw can be used for quick, accurate cuts. Dry-fitting the panel is a key step. Place the 1/2 inch building panel into the channel and against the studs. With a marker, mark a line where the Riolito base meets the building panel. Also, make marks on the studs just above the building panel. This will confirm that the panel was fully seated in the channel. Wedi shower installations use our joint sealant in and on top of all seams for adhesion and waterproofing. Ensure all channels and connections are free of debris before using the joint sealant. The installer applies a continuous 1/2 inch by 1/2 inch bead of sealant through the entire length of the channel. The building panel is positioned and seated in the 1/2 inch channel, compressing the joint sealant. The marks the installer made on the studs earlier help ensure the building panel is fully seated in the 1/2 inch channel. We will apply a second bead of sealant later in the installation. The Wedi shower system uses screws and washers for anchoring of the building panels directly to studs. Do not use any adhesives to glue the building panels to studs. It is also important not to place any screws in washers lower than 12 inches from the shower base. Starting at 12 inches, the installer anchors the building panel every 12 inches at every stud location. Remove any squeeze out of sealant with the putty knife. Dry fit the second panel. Apply a continuous half-inch bead of sealant along the edge of the already installed building panel. The second panel is positioned and installed, compressing the half-inch bead of sealant between the two panels. A screw and washer will be placed in the seam for flush anchoring. Continue every 12 inches on every stud. When starting a new wall, dry fit the panel using the same procedure as earlier and mark. Ensure there are no gaps where the building panels meet. This time, sealant will also be applied vertically in between the panel being installed and the building panels already installed. Ensure a tight fit into the channel and against the existing panel. Begin anchoring in the corner on a slight angle to maintain compression. Then, anchor the building panel with the screws and washers every 12 inches like before. In the corners where the panels meet, offset your washers so they do not create a void. Always remember to flatten any sealant that has squeezed out. Repeat this process to install the remaining wedi building panels. The installer is using a 2-inch lean curb AT for this installation. The AT curbs feature a 1/2-inch hard top for glass anchoring. This provides a safe anchoring point without compromising the waterproofing. This will be a wrapped or two-sided curb. The curbs will have to be mitered where they intersect to ensure the slope built into the top of the curb remains consistent. Measure for the length of the curb, also taking into consideration the extra length needed for the miter. It is best practice to cut your miter first, then cut the curb to the length. This will provide a bit more flexibility if adjustments are needed. If the saw blade does not go all the way through the curb, complete the cut using a handsaw. Always dry fit your curbs before installation. In some cases, modifications may have to be made to properly sit in the base's channel. Apply a 1/2-inch bead of sealant to the channels of the Riolito. You will also apply a bead of sealant in a snake-like pattern to the subfloor. The lean curb can be installed with thinset or sealant to the subfloor. A third continuous bead of sealant will also be applied to the curb channel. Position the curb in place and apply pressure to compress the sealant. Use a small level to ensure the face of the curb is plumb. This will maintain the factory slope on the wedi curb. When placing the second curb, apply sealant on the angle where they intersect. Remove any sealant squeeze out with the putty knife. Now it is time to apply a second bead of joint sealant to the seams. Working in sections, apply a 1/2-inch bead of sealant to all seams in the shower assembly. When working on an inside angle, use the corner putty knife to flatten the sealant. It is important that the sealant flattens to a minimum of 1 inch past the seam in both directions. Use a flat knife for the flat seams. The same flat knife will be used for the screw and washer locations. Apply sealant to the washer areas and flatten the sealant, ensuring it goes past the washer 1 inch in all directions. It is recommended to address the plumbing penetrations in a wedi shower with a flexi collar for the valve area and a waterproof sealing collar for the shower head. The installer will use sealant for the collars. Apply a few beads of sealant and flatten it with a putty knife. Attach the collars and ensure the membrane flange is completely embedded into the sealant. The last step is installing the Riolito drain cover. When tiling, use the gray spacers as a guide for where to stop your tile installation. They also include a threaded nut to assist in modifying the height of the drain cover's legs if needed. When setting the height of the drain cover, be sure to account for the thinset as well as the thickness of your tile. The legs are threaded and can be adjusted for the perfect height. In some cases, they may need to be cut for a lower profile. Use a fine-tooth saw and follow the provided lines on the leg. For a clean finished look, utilize Wedi Riolito channel frame to cover the raw or cut edge of tile. With Wedi's Fundo Riolito linear drain system, you can provide a contemporary, modern style to any shower with ease.